Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss something about sharpening a chef knife. Those who are new to my channel, I just want to tell you guys that I am explaining the theory of food production, that is kitchen knowledge, in detail a chef should know. I am explaining all this from the beginning and that too in detail, covering all the small points as well. Do hit the like button, do watch it till the end. It will be really helpful to all you guys. Do hit the like button, share it with all your friends and families. So let's get started. So coming to the first point, it says that sharpening is the process of creating a sharp edge of appropriate shape with the help of a sharpening tool. So basically, sharpening tool, which we will be going to discuss ahead, are used to sharpen a chef knife by giving them a sharp cutting edge. The next point says that the process of sharpening a chef knife is done by grinding away materials on implementing of an abrasive substance harder than the material of the implement. So in easy words, it means that the sharpening tool should have an abrasive material surface which should be sharper than the material of the chef knife, so that in the process of grinding, it could brush away the particles from the edge, from the cutting edge of a chef knife, in results giving a sharper edge. Coming back to the point, it sometimes followed by a process to follow the sharp surface to increase the smoothness. In this page, we are going to discuss about different types of sharpening tools. So the first one and the most common one are the sharpening stone. Always remember to sharp the knife over the sharpening stone at a certain angle, which should be about 20 to 30 degrees. Maintain the same angle throughout the process to get a good sharp edge. The next point says that the stone should be moistened regularly with water or with oil. These stones are usually available in various grades, which refer to the grit size in the stone. Grit size is given as a number which indicates the special density of the particles. A higher number denotes higher density, and therefore smaller particles lead to a finer finish of the surface. So always starts with a lower number sharpening stone towards a higher number sharpening stone. So as you all can see in the picture, in the first picture, a chef is holding a chef knife and is grinding its edge on the sharpening stone. The next point says that Japanese traditionally use natural sharpening stones which are lubricated with water, as using oil on water stones reduces their effectiveness. The three basic types of sharpening stones are carbidium stones. These are the most common ones. Then the second one are the Arkansan stones. Then there are the diamond impregnated stones. The last point says that the sharpening stones these days are also called as the wheat stone. The next sharpening tool is the steel, which is also known as the honing rod. The first point says that steel should be used immediately after sharpening of a knife. Second point says that steel didn't shape a knife, rather than it hones the knife. That is, it realigns the shaping edge of the knife. Honing steel are used by lightly sliding the blade away from yourself along the steel while moving it down. The angle that should be formed between the rod and the knife should be around 20 to 25 degrees. The size of the honing steel rod is up to 1 foot, which is almost equal to 30 centimeters long. So as you all can see in the picture, so there is this extra area which is outcoming of the rod, as you also can see clearly in this picture. So this is basically known as the guard of the honing rod or steel rod, which in the ends protect the fingers of the chef while sharpening the chef knife. So in the fluency, in case a chef like sliding down the chef knife, and in case he or she hurts his or her fingers, so a guard in a honing rod is given so that they could prevent their fingers from cutting. So the last one we are going to discuss are the commercial sharpeners. The first point says that they are available in various shapes and sizes. Some are manual while the other are machine operated. The machine has a small rollers which are made out of the same material that are used for the sharpening steel. So these commercial sharpeners are very economic and also they are very easy to use. Commercial sharpeners have grooves through which the knife can be slide in, and for the sharpening, as you all can see easily in the picture, there's a man sliding the knife in the groove. So as you can see in the second picture, the man is sliding the knife through the grooves to sharpen the knife. So that's all for the day, guys. I hope that this video will help you to increase your knowledge. Make sure you hit the like button, comment down if you still have any doubts, share it with all your friends and family, and for more such knowledge, keep watching What the Food. Bye bye.